believe in yourself and all that you are. Know that there is something inside you that is greater than any obstacle. Welcome back, student, to Bharat Education Society's Kartika High School and Junior College. I, Mrs. Savita Srivastav, once again welcome everyone to our computer online class. I hope everyone is happy, healthy and safe. Welcome to computer online class. Microsoft Access for Class 8. So let us start with Chapter 5, Planning Database with Access. Chapter 5, Database Planning with Access. Database Planning with Access. When you create a new database, you will always want to make sure that it meets your data entry needs, such as viewing and reporting the data. Let us see the following steps give you a brief idea how to go about planning your database. First one, identify the purpose of database. The first step in designing a database is to identify what sort of data shall be stored, what output are expected from it, and how the data shall be processed. To do this, list down the aims, objective, and groups of information on a piece of paper. Aims of creating database. First one, first aim is to maintain record of all individual to the connected to school. Second aim is to locate and generate report of any individual in the school. For example, mark list, progress report, admission process, fees report, etc. Second one, designing the database structure. Tables are the core of a database. Identify how many tables are needed in the database and how the table will be related to each other. For example, I had given here database of the school. Now school is related with the students, teachers and others means other staff, clerical staff, pune, etc. So they are interrelated to each other with the school. Database structure. Think what the data for each table would be. The data should include everything that will meet the required output. This is the database structure of school. In this database, we have created three tables. Table 1 is students, table 2 is teachers, and table 3 is other staff. They are related to each other, and these three tables are related to main school database. Now in table 1, we are designing the structure of GR number, name, roll number, date of birth, house. So these are the field name and these are the data types. So we have set the data types according to the field name. Now second table is teachers. Now teachers structure we have designed for the data table is teacher's code, name, qualification, designation, date of joining. These are the field names and these are the data types. So data types are set again according to the field name. So teacher code will be there, teacher's name will be there, qualification, then designation means post. For example, Hindi teacher, English teacher, science teacher, Marathi teacher, etc. So designation will come here, principal, AHM, supervisor. So this part is regarding the designation. Then date of joining, when the teachers have joined their duty in the school. So when they had started working in the school, that is called date of joining. Now third table is considered as a staff. We have designed for staff, other staff like clerical staff, pune staff, etc. So here also we have designed the structure for the table. This is staff code, name, qualification, designation and date of joining. So this is the database structure of school, which is related to students, teachers, and other staff. Output reports of this database school. We had created a database school, and in this database school we have created three tables: table 1 student, table 2 teachers, table 3 other staff. So after creating a table, we have entered the records. The records will be in tabular format of data output. The table 1 is consist of students' record, table 2 is consist of teachers' record, and table 3 is consist of staff records. So this way we can create the structure of the database by creating the different tables. And here we have created three different tables in one database called school. Designing the database table structure. Tables are the core of a database. Identify how many tables are needed in the database and how the tables will be related to each other. Here we had created a school database, and in school database we have created three tables: table 1 student, table 2 teachers, and table 3 others. All these three are related to school database. Designing the field. Assign meaning and short name to the field name. So when we give the field name in table, we have to always use underscore in between the alphabets or the field name. For example, here GR number. In GR and underscore I have used here, and NO is a number. Then roll underscore number. So you can add only underscore while giving the field name, or you can leave the blank space. Here we don't have to enter full stop, exclamatory, bracket, space, or non-printable character is allowed. So here I had given again the same example, GR number underscore. You can define like this, underscore in between the alphabets while giving the field name. Fourth one is data types. Data types specify the types of data in each field can hold records accordingly. Now the first data type is text. We can enter alphabets and number, and it will be up to 255 characters. Means this type of data can hold alphabet and number up to 255 characters long. Then second one is memo. Memo means letter number, which will be up to 65,535 character. So we can get a long text here where we can enter the description of the thing or a person. Then number, we can only enter number, for example GR number, code number, etc. Then fourth one is date and time. You can enter date as well as time according to the data. Means expiry date, yeah, birth date, date of joining, etc. Currency, fifth one is currency of the data. Means currency of the country can be entered in this field of the, and the database can be currency. Auto number, automatically generated number. For example, number in the list 1, 2, 3, 4, it will be generated automatically. The next one is yes or no. Logical value. If you want to say yes, you can type Y. If you want to say no, you can type N. Then hyperlink. Hyperlink is used to set the example of HTTP. You can give the link of the website. Okay. The next is OLE object. OLE object means we can get a link with a different Word document, spreadsheet, PowerPoint presentation. For example, I had given you the image of the student. We can get the image of the product. You can take the image of the student. Whatever you want to link with a particular database, you can give the images in your database. So these are the different data types in your table. You can set the data types along with the field name. Primary key. Every table has a primary key. A primary key is a field or a combination of fields that uniquely identify each record in a table. No two records in a table should have the same value in every field. A primary key is a field or set of fields with value that are unique throughout the table. Value of the key can be used to refer to entire record because each record has different value for the key. Now here I had given the example on which you can set the primary key. For example, in school database we have seen GR number. For this you can set a primary key, teacher's code and staff code. So you can set the primary key on these field names. Now to set the primary key, we have to make use of design tab. Go to the design tab and click on primary key. Now you can see here the staff table is open and we had given the primary key and we have set it on the staff code. You can see this primary key. If you want to remove this primary key, again click on this primary key of the design tab. So it will be deactivated. So to activate and deactivate primary key, we have to select this primary key ribbon from design tab. Primary key is set in all the three tables. In student table, we had set the primary key on GR number. In teachers table, we have set the primary key in teachers code. And in staff table, we had set the primary key on staff code. Data validation. Data validation means to give a correct data, valid data. When data is entered in a table, there is possibility of a number of errors. So validation involves checking the data is entered to prevent any data entry error. So whichever data we enter in database, it should be verified and it should be valid. So here I had given the example, it is telling you to enter a correct email ID and type a proper name. So this is called validation. Creating database using design view. Creating a database file in Access. First you have to start the Access. Type Access in the search box and click on Microsoft Office Access 2007. 3. Select blank database. 4. Type a new database file name called school and click on create button. 5. Click on view and select design view from view ribbons of home tab. 6. Type table 1 name as student and click on OK button. 7. Type all field names and select data type as shown in the student table 1. Click on office button or file tab and select save button after entering all the field names and data type. Click on view tab and select data sheet view to add the records in the table students. Add 5 records in student table and save it again by using office button and click on save. Right click on student tab and click on save and close to close the student table. Now we will create a new table in a same database file school. To create a new table name as teachers, we have to click on create and select table from table ribbon. Click on table 1 and click on View from Views ribbon. Select Design View from Views ribbon. Select Design View and give the second table name as Teachers and click on OK button. Here you can see the Teachers table has been created. Type all the field names and select data type as shown in a Teachers table. Click on Office button or File tab and select the Save button to save the table in your school database. Here we have added 5 records in Teachers table. Right click on Teachers table tab and click on Save and Close option to close the Teachers table. Now we are creating a new third table, Staff table. So click on Create and select Table option from Tables ribbon. Now to give the table name, we have to click on Table 1 and select Design View from Views ribbon. Type the third table name as Staff and click on OK. So third table will be get created. Type all the field name and select data types as shown in a Staff table. Click on Office button or File tab to select Save option. Select Datasheet view to enter the records in Staff table. Add 5 records in Staff table. So students will meet you in next video with new chapter of MS Access. Be safe and healthy. Wear mask, save lives. Wear a face cover, wash your hands, keep a safe distance. Thank you. Goodbye.